you always come in with good news.
Thank you.
And we hope you, I mean, we all, we will win the bid, inshallah. If you allow me, I would like to request Dr. Mustafa to come onto the stage. He's the secretary of the Building Materials Group. And we will have good news, right, Mustafa?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Your Excellency, Mr. Ahmed Mahmoud, distinguished friends, ladies and gentlemen. We are honored to be here today in the Dubai Custom Week and in this presentation. And I'm glad to give a presentation on the Building Material Trading Group, which is under the auspices of Dubai Chamber. It was formed in 2002. Building Material Group is the largest in the economy after oil, one of the largest group. And as our experience of 6 decades in Dubai, since 1958, you know, we have seen Dubai emerging from a small village to a mega metro in just 6 decades and turning, you know, becoming the most favored destination of the world by any standards and any scale. In that, Dubai is also called the paradise of an architect. So you can see all the architects' dream fulfilling over here, and in every fulfillment of this dream, the core ingredients is a building material. Building material, as we see, you know, the trade, overall trade, scaling from 480 billion to 1.331 trillion in from 2005 to 14, giving a very consistent growth. And after the declaration of 2020, and now as we approach, you know, a timeline of 3 years down the road, the construction activities happening in Dubai currently is similar to what we experienced in 2008, or even it will surpass that figures. Dubai Customs played a very major role in creating our sector being successful. In that, the clearance, what we see in experience from the past and to the current, the very fast system of clearance and the goods scanning and screening happening is creating a good a base in the market, you know, for the trade happening, and a lot of re-exports. Building material, a lot of building material is also re-exported from Dubai. Once, it's about the entire North Africa depends on the exports from Dubai. Also the other GCC countries where Dubai is a major exporter of building material. And one of the largest exports are done to Saudi Arabia in the mega projects in Saudi Arabia. This is also giving you some of the general figures on the trade, and surpasses, you know, about 950 billion plus and from Jan to September of 16. And all the indicators show that this upward trend has become a catalyst to the building material business happening in Dubai. Some of the key areas and the pain points, you know, we'd like to highlight on the building material. In this course of fast development, there are certain illness, you know, in our sector which has emerged as a spurious product, which our other esteemed speakers have mentioned, short quantities. If you see the box of 100 in the market, you know, it's very often you can find, you know, the quantities are between 80, 85, but not reaching 100. So that's, you know, another area where we need to strengthen, you know, with the help of my customs. Another is misdeclaration of origin. That's a major factor, you know, in the building material, what we see as a pain point. And the material coming from any eastern country with the labels mentioned of the Western countries. So when the customers buy, looking at the box and the labels, now they are getting a product which is not to the standards. And the irony of our in the building material is what we see is the surface wall. The wallpapers are visible, but you cannot see the behind this. What cement used? What grade of steel used? What are the other construction the ingredients which goes into the making of the building? And that is a very key area where we need to, you know, little strengthen ourselves. We have been working with the Dubai Economic Department as well, you know, but you know there are certain these are all reactive measures where some complaints are done and then the raids are happening on and the products are seized. But in certain areas where it's very open and openly selling, you know, the counterfeit products are visible to the departments, and I request the Dubai custom, because it's the first point where the material is flowing to the country, and it's the first authority screening that. In this quantum of construction happening in the next 3 years, like, you know, the implied need of the fast car is good brakes. So with this quantum of construction happening, it's very important to see a quality check on the products and the material being consumed in the construction of the buildings. Otherwise, you know, the building looks fine for first 5 years or 10 years, and that is it goes into the major refurbishment, and or some other mishaps happens in which cost, you know, a dire to the humanity and a dent, you know, as well to the place. So Dubai Custom being can play a major role in this, and we seek your assistance, you know, in this. For that, we have some subject matter experts, you know, which we are also in the arbitration on Dubai courts, in the Dubai Planning Department on building material expertise on the products, and we have a team wherein, you know, sometimes it's random checks are required, and improving the quality, improving the deliverables, or whatever is mentioned and is delivered, it will improve the confidence of the buyer and confidence of the entire sector. The projects which are under pipeline are exceeding 629 billion, and every day, you know, few adding to this list, you know, creating a good scope and a major in-house requirement on the construction activity happening, which is the main ingredients are the building material suppliers. Of course, you know, this in the Dubai's foreign trade, there's a staggering growth of double digit, and this, you know, we have been experiencing for last many years. Dubai is, I always say in many of the occasions what we get opportunity, that it's the best blend of East and West. Very recently in the vibrant Gujarat, about 10 to 2 weeks back, we had an honor to host the chairman, Mr. Sultan Sulaim, in Ahmedabad with the Prime Minister Modi and all the key champions of the economy of the world were present there. And in that small discussion, you know, we initiated, you know, the role of Dubai Customs and the ports has really, you know, helped evolving Dubai into what the Dubai is today. And as you know, what we see right now is the tip of an iceberg, but a major transformation coming down the road will definitely, you know, improve the position of Dubai in all the index. So with this, you know, the building material is the backbone of the construction, and certain origins and certain the brands, as our brand protection, you know, department mentioned, because we are based in business in Dubai since 1958, and we are custodians of some of the big brands of building material, and we see a lot of punishment on our sale because of the spurious products like the Hilti is the Rolls Royce of the power tools. We are the one to introduce Hilti in the entire Gulf in 1969. So it's the imitations are many a time. It's with the contractors also. We have to play a major role. Contractors play a major role in this, supporting this illicit activities. Not all, but of course, few of them. In the store, in the construction site, in the store, all the original materials are kept as the samples. And so whenever you inspect the store, you will find all materials in order. But when it goes in the real construction, that's where the activities are happening. And as my education, I did master's in criminology from UK, so I can easily identify the flaws and happening and the leakages in the gap. So with this improvement in this sector, where certain corrections are required, definitely the life of the building and the life of the construction will improve, and not only going for L1, L2 in the construction, but using the right product for the right application, that's where improves the life of the construction activities. With this, I'd like to end my presentation and thank Dubai Custom for giving us this opportunity and working closely with the market. And this is where you get the pulse, from direct pulse from the market. And we are again thankful to Your Excellency, and we are always at your service for improvement and betterment of the coming days. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Saasa. Can you just stay for 1 minute on the stage? Dr. Mustafa, I meet him in training every time he goes for training. He doesn't stop learning all the time. So, one of the things that I'd like to ask you, remember last year we had our DCC meeting and you had a request to His Excellency Sultan Bislain, the chairman of DP World, the chairman of Ports and Customs and Free Zone, and you had some good news on that.
Yes, sir.
So I would like you to highlight on that.
Sure. Thank you for reminding this. Building material city was declared in 2004, and about 800 members participated in that, and in the happening of that city. But due to some reason, that thing had never happened. And last year, in the one of this meet, reminded His Excellency Mr. Sultan that now Dubai is at the threshold of a major transformation, and the upcoming of 2020 and the projects down the line, what we see, this building material city is a need of an hour right now. And that time, he connected me to Mr. Adil Zaruni in Jebel Ali, and with that, a 6-kilometer mall is taking shape in the south of Jebel Ali, which all the retails of the retails and the wholesales of the building material will be moving, will have an opportunity to move in that excellent location. See, the epicenter of the city keeps on changing. I always say people that earlier Jamia Square was the center of Dubai, and then it moved to the Mall of Emirates, and now for the trading hub, the near vicinity of Jebel Ali is the epicenter. And opposite this site is the World Trade Expo 2020 site. Diagonally on the right is the world's largest airport coming up, and the back of this this mall, the world's largest port. So with this, a great opportunity for building material, which emerged with the discussion of His Highness, His Excellency, Mr. Sultan, is taking shape, and very soon by 18, we are hoping that this building material city and this retail complex will take shape, and we see a major relocation of building material city, the trainers over there.
Thank you. I was waiting for this good news, actually, because we will have. Thank you, doctor. I think we will have more logistics, we more shipping, we will have more custom duty, inshallah. And Dubai deserves.
Of course.
Dubai deserves that we all work for it and do our best for Dubai. the most happiest city in the world, and for sure.